Hello. Welcome to this new episode of the Machine Learning Essentials series. I'm Nishant Tucker, and in this video, we'll talk about securing your machine learning environments. Now, security is a topic that is very important for organizations of all sizes. Recent events have further renewed the rigor around ensuring that security isn't being compromised. Since it's one of the biggest reasons machine learning projects get stuck, it is important to think of security from the very beginning instead of trying to patch it in at the end. We'll take the next few minutes to understand the various aspects of security within Azure Machine Learning and how you can secure your resources inside Azure. We'll break this down into four areas. One, authentication and authorization. Two, network security. Three, data encryption. And four, policy and monitoring. Let's get started. The first thing to understand is how do we restrict access to resources and operations? Authentication to Azure Machine Learning Workspace is based on Azure Active Directory or Azure AD. In general, there are three authentication workflows that you can use when connecting to the workspace. Interactive, where you use your account in Azure Active Directory to either directly authenticate or to get a token that is used for authentication. Interactive authentication enables you to control access to resources such as web services on a per-user basis. Then you have Service Principal, where you can create a Service Principal account in Azure Active Directory and use that to authenticate or get a token. A Service Principal is used when you need an automated process to authenticate to the service without requiring user interactions. For example, a CI/CD script that trains and tests a model every time the training code changes. And then you have managed identity. When using the Azure Machine Learning SDK on Azure Virtual Machines, you can use a managed identity on Azure. This workflow allows the VM to connect to the workspace using the managed identity without storing credentials and Python code or prompting the user to authenticate interactively. Azure Machine Learning compute clusters can also be configured to use a managed identity to access the workspace when training models. It can communicate with services like Azure Container Registry or ACR via these managed keys instead of requiring admin keys for the ACR, which could be a difficult ask for most enterprises. Regardless of the authentication type used, role-based access control or RBAC is used to scope the level of access allowed for the resources. For example, an account that is used to get the access token for a deployed model only needs read access to the workspace. This is what we call authorization. Let's see how that works. In Azure Machine Learning, you can create multiple workspaces and each workspace can be shared by multiple people. When you share a workspace, you can control access to it by assigning specific roles to users. There are three built-in roles: owner, contributor, and reader. Of course, their roles correspond to specific rights to operations within the workspace. Now, here's a pro tip. If the built-in roles don't meet your needs, you can create custom roles. These can help you define roles that are best suited for your team structures and organizational policies. Now, custom roles are supported to control all operations inside the workspace, such as creating a compute, submitting a run, registering a data store, or deploying a model. Custom roles can have read, write, or delete permissions on the various resources of a workspace, such as clusters and data stores and models and endpoints. You can make the role available at a specific workspace level, a specific resource group level, or even at the subscription level. These roles are used to secure compute targets and data. Owners and contributors can use all compute targets and data stores that are attached to the workspace. Now that we understand the authentication and authorization aspects, let's look at network security. To restrict network access to Azure Machine Learning resources, you can use virtual networks. VNets allow you to create network environments that are partially or fully isolated from the public internet. This reduces the attack surface for your solution, as well as the chances of data exfiltration. You might use a virtual private network or a VPN gateway to connect individual clients on your own network to the VNet. But network security is not only about putting your ML workspace inside a VNet, A machine learning environment typically interacts with a bunch of other services like storage, container registry, Kubernetes service, etc. We should ensure that these services can also communicate securely with the machine learning workspace. This is where Private Link comes in. The Azure Machine Learning Workspace can use Azure Private Link to create a private endpoint behind the VNet. This provides a set of private IP addresses that can be used to access the workspace from within the VNet. Some of the services that Azure Machine Learning relies on can also use Azure Private Link, but some rely on network security groups or user-defined routing. This private IP, also sometimes referred to as no public IP, is a must-have for a lot of enterprises to ensure there is nothing open to the public internet. Azure Machine Learning provides the capabilities to ensure end-to-end private IP deployments for your machine learning environments with VNets and Azure Private Link. Here's another pro tip. The Azure Machine Learning team has a dedicated ARM template within Azure Quick Start templates that deploys the secure configuration seamlessly. You don't need to worry about setting this up on your own. We've tackled users and networks. Now it's time to secure the data. As part of the machine learning process, you may bring in data from a variety of sources and register them as data stores or data sets. All this data can be encrypted by customer managed keys. But while these sources may have their own security capabilities, when they interact with Azure Machine Learning and share data to be processed inside its workspace, there is a need for encryption both at rest and in transit. Here's another pro tip. If your workspace contains sensitive data that needs encryption at rest, Azure Machine Learning provides a flag called HPI_workspace, which should be set appropriately while creating your workspace itself. Now, the HPI workspace flag controls the amount of data Microsoft collects for diagnostic purposes and enables additional encryption in Microsoft-managed environments. In addition, it performs the following actions. First, it starts encrypting the local disk in your Azure Machine Learning compute clusters. Second, it cleans up your local disk between runs. Third, it securely passes credentials for your storage account, container registry, and SSH account from the execution layer to your compute clusters using the key vault. And finally, it enables IP filtering to ensure underlying batch pools cannot be called by any external services other than the Azure Machine Learning service. Additionally, Azure Machine Learning stores some metadata in an Azure Cosmos DB instance. It is important to note that this metadata just contains some operational information such as run history. It does not have any sensitive data such as trained model, trained results, or anything like that. This Cosmos DB instance where the metadata is stored is associated with a Microsoft subscription managed by Azure Machine Learning. All the data stored in Azure Cosmos DB is encrypted at rest with Microsoft managed keys. If needed, the user has the option to configure all of these with customer managed keys as well. This includes the storage, the container registry, the container instance or Kubernetes, or even the Cosmos DB instance where the metadata is stored. To use your own customer managed key to encrypt the Azure Cosmos DB instance, you can create a dedicated Cosmos DB instance for use within your workspace. We recommend this approach if you want to store your data, such as run history information, outside of the multi-tenant Cosmos DB instance hosted within the Microsoft-owned subscriptions. Now, these actions ensure your data is secure and encrypted at rest. Now, let's look at encryption in transit. Azure Machine Learning uses TLS 1.2, which is a cryptographic protocol designed to provide communication security over a computer network. Azure uses TLS 1.2 to secure internal communications between various Azure Machine Learning microservices. All Azure storage access also occurs over a secure channel. On similar lines, all external calls made to the scoring endpoints also happen over TLS. Here's another pro tip. For production-grade encryption during training, we recommend using Azure Machine Learning compute clusters, and similarly, for production-grade encryption during inference, we recommend using Azure Kubernetes service. The Azure Machine Learning compute instance is a dev test environment. When using it, we recommend that you store your files such as notebooks and scripts in a file share, and your data should also be stored in a data store. The next important aspect of securing your machine learning environment is the ability to enforce policies and monitoring the workspace effectively. Azure Machine Learning integrates with Azure Policy and the Azure Security Center, which provides Microsoft-created and managed definitions related to different compliance standards. There are several policy options with network security and data protection that can be applied via Azure Policy. For example, an organization can ensure that no machine learning workspace is created without a private link configured. Enabling observability across today's complex computing environments running distributed applications requires the collection of operational data from every layer and every component of the system. You need to be able to derive deep insights from this data and consolidate it into a single pane of glass with different perspectives to support the multitude of stakeholders in your organization. Azure Monitor collects and aggregates data from a variety of sources into a common data platform where it can be used for analysis, visualization, and alerting. It provides a consistent experience on top of data from multiple sources, which gives you a deep insights across all your monitored resources and even with data from other services that store the data in Azure Monitor. It can provide you the ability to capture both metrics and workspace activity logs. This ensures you have granular details on everything that is happening inside your Azure Machine Learning workspace. Here's another pro tip. Azure Monitor's metrics data is available for 90 days. However, when you're creating charts, only 30 days can be visualized inside a single chart. If you want to visualize a full 90-day period, you can break it into three charts of 30 days within the 90 days. We've covered a lot in this short video, but security is a vast topic and only one of the components of enterprise readiness. Azure also provides capabilities and templates for cost management, deployment planning, differential privacy, and even confidential computing. But we'll leave that for another day. To summarize, in this video, we observed that Azure Machine Learning provides easy-to-use and seamlessly integrated capabilities around access control, network isolation, data encryption, and policy and monitoring. All these can be configured in an automated way using either the command line interface or ARM templates, or even designing your own tools with the REST APIs provided. These are important as with these automation capabilities, organizations of all sizes can ensure that they can enable their data science teams to innovate and deliver value securely. All this without having to get exceptions from the IT and compliance organizations. Well, that's it for this video. As always, to try out these capabilities on Azure, please spin up a free Azure Machine Learning workspace at aka.ms/aml-trial. And also download the 30-day learning journey from the Data Scientist Resources page at aka.ms/data-scientists. See you in another episode of the Machine Learning Essentials series.